Right. Does anyone have a question?
Yeah, we have one question.
Go away.
We have global crisis in the world. Can you tell us how we can fix that problem? You like PR, like people who are PR.
Well, the greatest thing that's been lost is not the money. The greatest thing that's been lost in this crisis is trust. And what we can do as public relations people, through our own ethical approach, we can build our trust, and as messages for governments, for businesses, etc., then we can help them to build trust. And that is the way back to prosperity.
That's mean without money.
Money comes, but people are not going to lend money unless they trust the institutions that are lending it, unless they trust the people who are borrowing it. Mm-hmm. So trust is just integral to it.
What you can say these people here today in the Congress?
I'm going to talk about crisis. Mm-hmm. And crisis is not so much about even anticipation, it's not so much about what you do during it, it's what happens after the crisis that's important, because that's where you rebuild from whatever the outcome of whatever the event is that has caused this change in your own circumstances.
Anyone?
What are the new trends in PR profession?
The new trends in PR profession are really what they've always been. They are a reaction to changing circumstances. For example, about 5 years ago, 2 years ago, we didn't have the social media that we have today. The consequences of the social media mean that we, the public relations people, have to change. We have to think of the new channels that we have available to us. We're not just talking about newspapers, we're not talking just about television, not talking about radio. We now have other channels to use to get our message out. But equally, on the other side, other people now have the possibility of having their own voice. So they don't rely on us as gatekeepers, they don't rely on the media as gatekeepers. So we've had to react to that. And that brings in a whole new perspective of the requirements of public relations. Because if you don't have a media gatekeeper who checks the material that a public relations person is putting out, then that puts a lot of responsibility on the public relations person to tell the truth, to give balance to what he is saying, to listen to what other people are saying, rather than just one-way propaganda material. So that's the principal change I see.
One question. Can you talk about politics in PR?
Well, politics and public relations are exactly the same thing. Exactly the same thing. Just take the two words, public relations. Public relations is about the interface between somebody who wants something to say and somebody that they want to listen to and to get that message back and forth. Politics is exactly the same. Politics is really about an individual, it can be an individual, a group, who form themselves into a larger group, can be a political party, who agree on something, and they go through the same process. They express their opinion, they get feedback, they maybe alter their opinion, and at some point, somebody makes a judgment about it. Now, in public relations, that judgment can be rather simple, can't it? You go into a shop, you've read something that public relations has told you, and you buy a product. With politics, somebody tells you, this is what I'm going to do, you believe him, etc., so you vote for him.
Can I beg to the same question about the America and the intervention into the Iraq? Weapons of mass destruction. They have a very good PR, they convince the rest of the world about the problem, and they intervene and they found nothing. How about the trust and PR about that?
It's a difficult situation to recover from, obviously. But, you know, I think the world now has passed on to other things. It is accepted that that was not the justification that at the time it appeared to be. And lots of people, including Colin Powell, who presented that at the United Nations, have expressed their opinion about it. So what there is, yes, you had a situation where something was said. Subsequently, people don't trust that. So again, I come back to what I said before. It's about rebuilding trust.
Yes,
it is. Rebuilding trust.
Yeah, that is the point, the rebuilding trust. But we can say that we are managed by the PRs very successfully, and it is actually sorry.
No. You're not managed by public relations. You know, all of us have a responsibility, not just to take information in, but to analyze that critically. That's our responsibility. If you say to me, we're being managed, then we're back to the days of propaganda, where somebody tells you what to think about everything, tells you what to do about everything, and takes all of that personal judgment, if you like, takes that away from you.
Do the politicians have a license to lie?
The answer, you'd have to be I'd have to be a liar if I said no.
Thank you.
It is exactly the same situation that we are all faced with, aren't we? You can tell the truth, but sometimes the truth is not really the total truth. It's just that little white lie. You know, you can say to me, I like your tie, because you're being nice to me. In reality, you think it's a horrible tie.
Thank you.
That's the sort of circumstance you're in. And also one, when we're making judgments about people, whether people are telling us the truth or not, all that we can say, any of us can say, at this moment in time, this is the truth as I understand it. Because truth is not black and white. Truth is a grey area. Your perception of an event is different from somebody else's perception of an event. So what's the truth? Is it the fact that, you know, there was a robbery and somebody saw two men? There was a robbery and somebody saw one man? What's the truth? Well, until we've gone through the process of gathering evidence, etc., then we have the truth.